Family, my name is Kenisa, and today we are doing a little vlog. So today is Wednesday, October 30th, day before Halloween, and on Sunday, Bailey kind of started limping, and so we are a bit concerned. But ever since Bailey was a puppy, we kind of knew she had loose joints in her knees. So sometimes she'll do that, and the doctor told us it may pop out. Her knee may pop out, but it should pop back in. So she's limped before, but then after a few minutes, she's fine. But on Sunday, she kind of didn't stop limping. So then I called Banfield Monday morning, and we tried to get her in. They didn't have anything available till Tuesday. So Tuesday morning, I took her to Banfield. We did a drop-off appointment. Dropped her off at like 7, and then she's ready to go about noon. But long story short, the doctor tried to pop her knee back into place and it wouldn't stay. It keeps popping out of the joint. And so he said that she would need to go to a specialist and she would need surgery. So we drove to Columbia, South Carolina, which is a little bit over an hour away from where we live. And we are now waiting to see the specialist in Columbia at the DCA Animal Hospital. So we're just hanging out, waiting for the vet to open. It's 7:45 now. We left at like 6:30. So just waiting for it to open. So I'll show you guys Bailey. This is a little Bailey. So she doesn't, like, if I touch it and if I move it, it doesn't hurt. It just hurts, I guess, when she walks on it. She won't put her weight on it. Or like she'll put some weight on it, but it just, her leg just looks weird. Or if she's trying to run really fast, she'll just lift that one up and run on 3. So we're just kind of waiting to see what they let us know. So today we did come on a surgery day, so they'll be able to do her consultation. They already have her information from Banfield. They faxed it over in the referral. So they'll do her consultation today, and then if they determine that she does in fact need surgery, she'll go ahead and get her surgery today as well. So she wasn't able to eat breakfast or anything. She had to get up super early. Bailey, bebe, you okay? You okay, bebe? Anyways, guys, so the doctor opens at 8, so we're going to go in at 8, get signed in, hopefully get seen fairly quickly. So we'll keep you guys posted.
She go into the bathroom normally, drinking normally, eating normally?
Yeah.
Okay. Any vomiting or diarrhea that's been happening?
First of all, luxating patella. So the patella is a little model of the dog's knee here. So this is kind of the bottom portion of the femur and the top portion of the tibia or the shin bone. That patella, that's another word for just kneecap. Mm-hmm. So that kneecap, that's this little bone here, and it sits in this big thick tendon. This bone sits quite nicely in a normal dog. Sits quite nicely in this little groove, so you can see it just kind of sits right there. Mm-hmm. And so then when the dog, you know, flexes and extends their knee, mm-hmm. that kneecap moves in that groove. Mm-hmm. Now what goes on in Bailey's knee is that she has what we call medial luxating patella. Medial means to the inside, and so that kneecap will pop over to the inside here. Mm-hmm. Luxating means just pop out a joint, and patella is just another word for kneecap. Mm-hmm. And so what happens is in these little dogs, Yorkies, Chihuahuas, all these little tiny guys, it's something that they're typically born with, mm-hmm. and which is why you guys, you know, were told about this when she was a puppy. Mm-hmm. A lot of dogs that have this can lead happy, normal lives and don't necessarily need surgery, even though they don't have normal knees. Mm-hmm. You know, a lot of times they just compensate and they don't have lameness or pain or anything like that. And so at that point, we don't typically fix those guys. The dogs that we try to recommend doing surgery on are the ones that are having significant issues with mm-hmm. that luxating patella, because what happens is that kneecap can pop in and out like this, yeah. and it's uncomfortable. Yeah. And the way that we know that it's uncomfortable is that they start holding up that leg, mm-hmm. and they start holding it up more and more and more, and we know, okay.
All right, guys. So we just got done with the consultation with Bailey, and unfortunately, we had to leave her there. So we have to leave her overnight. She has to stay overnight. I tried to see Vanessa her way out of there and see if she can come home, but they said that she has to be there because the amount of pain she's going to be in, and she's going to be heavily sedated. And then she has to do physical therapy. She has to do laser treatment. So she'll have to do a lot of things after her knee surgery. So Jaren will get off work early tomorrow and go pick her up on actual...
Oh, it'll be Halloween Day.
So we'll pick her up on the 31st tomorrow. We are headed back home now. And I'm just really sad to leave her. I've never left any of my dogs in a place like that. I mean, Marley got sick the one time and they wanted me to leave him there, but I refused, of course. But I've never left them there, so I'm just nervous for her. We were able to leave her a blanket, and then we were able to get her some special food, because you guys know she had an allergic reaction.
I'm going to post that video.
But I'm going to post it. So you guys, you know, she had an allergic reaction to some food, so I went and got her some other medicated canned foods just to make sure that she's fine and comfortable. We left her a little blanket from home that she usually lays on.